My first guest this evening is no stranger to Lycra and spandex gusset. He's a man of muscle, sinew and sweat, and my dressing room number's 189. Would you please put your hands together for Rhino from Gladiators? Do you know what I mean? Harvey, I went up for Gladiators. Yeah. We were going to be the new Gladiators.
What were you going to call yourself?
I was going to be Veruca. And Harvey was going to be Cystitis, but we got changed. Next to Rhino is a very distinguished actress. She spends most of her time dressed in a plastic mac and white high-heeled shoes, cycling around the Yorkshire Dales, preying on older men. She's from Last of the Summer Wine. Would you please welcome Jean Ferguson? Jean! And Jean, of course, is she's had a huge success with it. She knows you know, haven't you? Ooh, she's doing Hilda Baker. Do a bit of Hilda, go on.
No man has ever dallied with my afflictions. And I say that without fear of contraception.
Be soon, go on, be soon.
Soon,
we all have a constipated here.
You're better at it than me.
I'm not too tough, but I'd have to be Cynthia. We'll have Hilda Baker now. You can do Hilda Noel, can't you, Les?
Hilda Ogden, I can do Hilda Ogden.
Baker, we're on about.
Baker, yes. Baker. Ronnie this Baker, one. Barker. No, lost it, totally. Forget it. I think you look lovely, by the way, Lil.
I didn't ask your opinion. When I want it, Les, I'll slap it out of you. Thank you very much.
You should do that new movie, Whatever Happened to Baby Spice?
That's just going to happen to her. What happens when she hits 40? She can't be called Baby Spice, can she? It is Baby Spice. I like the Spice Girls, but if you notice, Baby Spice is the only one who can't remember the routines. All the others are going, and Baby Spice is going... Shoes they wear, gone to traffic and walk, can you? Next to Jean on the end here now, what can I say about my next guest? Nothing at this hour of the night. We couldn't get Ronan from Boyzone, so we got a stuntman instead. He's blonde, he's tanned, and none of it's come out of a bottle. Would you please welcome the one and only Mr. Mike Smith, Michael?
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Nice to see you. We've had many a good time in the Midland Hotel, Manchester, haven't we?
Yes, hey. We have. We have.
I'm doing
you
the baking.
You taught me so much.
You taught me a few things and all, I tell you. Things you can do with eggs and a tub of Vaseline, I never knew. Now, this little sausage here. When I was a child actress studying theatre and dance at the Birkenhead Academy of Dramatic Arts... My ambition was to be in a long-running soap. Now, I couldn't hope to get an Emmerdale Farm or Coronation Street, because it was just a dream, wasn't it? And then at last the BBC introduced a real down-market series, and there seemed to be a chance. I mean, I've been close to the part many, many times, but Doc Cotton keeps coming back, so about this. Now, my next guest's been on the show a very long time. She's matured along with the character, although a trumpet playing's a load of crap. Would you please put your hands together for Natalie Cassidy? Natalie!
You do look lovely, Lily.
Oh, thank you very much. Have you got your trumpet?
I haven't got it with me.
Oh, no. Remember the old saying, bump it with a trumpet.
I remember that. Go,
I'll show you later. Now, next to Natalie, well, he's an old hand, this kind of game. He's been on Family Fortunes for 12 years. That's why he twitches. You must have done something evil, Levers, in the past life, I tell you, to deserve that.
Would you wake up listening to that, you wake up to that blankety-blank, I wake up to eh-eh.
What is it?
Follows me around
what
everywhere.
What is it we say? Our panel said, not panel, what is
our,
it?
Our survey said,
eh-eh. It's like a Teletubby, isn't it? Eh-eh. A Teletubby whose voice is broke. Put your hands together, please, for Les Dennis. Let's see ya. Brad just twigged, we're very scoused tonight, aren't we?
We are, aren't we?
Yeah. Because sat next to Les here on the end, she played the posh one from The Whittle in Watching. Well, everyone's posh from The Whittle, aren't they? Let's face it. She also was sprung from the loins of a very famous TV star, and it wasn't Huey Green for a change. Would you please welcome Lisa Tarbuck?
Thank you.
How are you there?
Not bad at all, thank you.
Got your hair up.
Princess Margaret.
Oh, no, you suit that with your hair up.
balances out my jowl.
No, it looks nice all swept up like that. Don't you think?
I think you should do it.
Put my head up. Yeah. No, look, I'm out of Hindley, look. That won't go out, will it? I do though, look. I've been in Sainsbury's and people have said, when did you get out? I've been on the freezer, digging through the man's towel. So what do you mean by that?